I would like to invite and introduce the first speaker from Lithuanian electricity transmission company, Litgrid, Kęstutis Sveta, who will introduce the GIS usage of Litgrid company and how it interconnects with other systems and how it works in the daily work. So Kęstutis, stage is yours.
Hello, everyone. I'm Kęstutis Sveta, data platform development project manager from Litgrid. Today I will talk about the role of GIS in the maintenance process of electricity transmission network. So let's begin. At first, I would like briefly introduce the company I represent. Litgrid is Lithuanian electricity transmission system operator that operates Lithuanian electricity transmission grid. We maintain a stable operation of national electricity network, ensuring reliable, efficient, high quality, transparent, and safe transmission of electricity. We maintained around 7,000 kilometers of overhead lines, 300 kilometers of cable lines, and over 250 transformer substations. In our company, we use GIS products such as ArcGIS Enterprise, ArcGIS Online, ArcGIS Survey, and ArcGIS Pro. ArcGIS Enterprise is used to develop and view GIS application for internal use. The majority of the company GIS users use these GIS products. As for ArcGIS Online, we use it to develop GIS applications, which are made accessible to the public in our company websites. Also, in ArcGIS Online, we have developed a GIS application portal for our maintenance contractors, but I will talk about that in the next slides. Using ArcGIS Survey, we inspect electricity transmission network lines and digitize the measurements protocols of substation devices. And ArcGIS Pro is used to update data, launch data configuration tools, and perform geospatial analysis. In our company, we have two GIS application portals. One portal is for internal use, and second portal is for contractors. Now I will briefly introduce the four main GIS applications that are used in electricity transmission network maintenance processes. So the first application is the electricity transmission network map. It shows the electricity transmission network with characteristics, and so we can see crossings with railways, roads, and other utility networks. This map is used as a tool to help staff plan, order, or coordinate maintenance work. The second application is map of induction voltage in the overhead lines of the electricity transmission network. It shows the induced voltage zones of overhead lines with modeled values. The induced voltage are generated by calculator, which was developed in collaboration with scientists. When overhead lines run parallel to each other, they create electromagnetic field that generates inducted voltage. Extra safety measures must be taken when organizing work on such lines, as induced voltage can be generated on disconnected lines, which can be dangerous for personnel. In MAP, when you enter line name, the line is zoomed in and it provides information about the simulated induction voltage on that line and information about the lines that induced the voltage. The third application is application which is intended for recording and administration of activities in the protection zone of electric transmission lines. It includes information of the granted approvals for activities and detected violation in electricity transmission line protection zones. According to current legal requirements in Lithuania, the activities in electricity transmission network protection zones requires the permission of electricity transmission system operator. Approval is required for activities such as building buildings, installing fans, planting trees, and other similar activities in line protection zone. A transmission line protection zone is the strip of land located along the axis of power line whose sites are away from the edge wires of the line. The map shows the plots of land for which permits have been granted for the construction of buildings or other activities in line protection zones. Also, the map indicates the register violations. Violations are activities that are not permitted or are forbidden by law in line protection zones. The app provides statistics of permits granted and violations registered. And the fourth application is map of connecting renewable energy power plants to the transmission grid. This application shows preliminary information on the generation capacities that can be connected to the network. It also provides information about preconditions of connections, intentions protocols, and power plants connected to the transmission grid. You can filter information by voltage, years, and other parameters. This map is important for renewable energy developers. This application is accessible to the public in our company website. Now I would like to talk about our solution for inspections of electricity transmission network lines. We have developed ArcGIS survey form that allows employees to capture defects of electricity transmission lines. A line engineer who is inspecting transmission line opens ArcGIS survey on tablet, then chooses inspection form and start inspection. In the pictures on the slide, you can see the form of line inspection. Once the inspection is completed, the engineer saves the data and it's transferred to GIS database. The asset management system takes the defect data from GIS database and generates work orders and line inspections sheets. The engineer opens the asset management system, checks the automatically generated work orders, and sends them to the contractors to fix defects. Also, the data from the inspections are accessible in Power BI and used for a wide range of analysis. At the same time, we are working on the digitization of the protocols. We have developed digital forms of several measurement protocols for substation devices. Further, we are developing these forms, which will be used by contractors to take measurements of all substation devices. For measurements of substation equipment parameters, the contractor open ArcGIS survey on tablet or PC, then choose the form of the measurement and start entering the data. Once the measurements are completed, The contractor saves data and it's transferred to GIS database. PDF protocol is generated and automatically attached to specific word order in the asset management system. The protocol data is accessible also in Power BI and used of various analysis and network health prediction model. Another interesting field in which we working is the use of LiDAR data. To fully exploit the potential of LiDAR data in our work, we decide to create own LiDAR data configuration tools. Currently, we have developed tools to create 3D model of the electricity transmission lines and the terrain in the line protection zone. The result of the tools are used for planning works and coordinating activities in line protection zones. In the pictures on the slide, you can see intermediate results of these tools. The data configuration tools are run in ArcGIS Pro. The tools create future layers which are transferred to GIS portal. There will be application in GIS portal where generated data from LiDAR tools will be published. Also, we plan to develop another LiDAR configuration tools, such as tool to identify vegetation, the line protection zone, tool to identify the maintenance of forest clearings, tool for identifying line crossings, and so on. That's the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Kastutis. It was really interesting for me, especially the last part, using the innovations and then trying to also, from data which you have, make some possible things, make assets. So I saw that we have some questions.
Yes, we have, and I just wanted to remind you, please use Slido if you want to ask questions. So at the other side of your badge, there is a QR code. So use it to ask questions in the Slido. So, but we have some of questions. So what is your asset management system and how it is linked with GIS database?
And now we use IFS asset management system, and it links in integration from IFS to GIS or GIS to IFS.
It is database integration.
Database integration.
Okay. And actually, two very similar questions. How large is your team? I mean, this asset management divisions, how many data editors, administrators, and GIS analysts you have?
This answer is very hard for me because we have a lot users who use GIS application, but GIS analytics, we have one, me. We have editors, but they edit a little information, and I developed the results, products, and so on.
So you are the main person who drives GIS in company.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. So use your opportunity to ask personally questions after this session. Thank you very much for your presentation.
Thank you, Kastutis. And one thing, small gift.
Thank you
again, and very impressive, interesting presentation.